20th overall pick in the 1971 draft, Larry Robinson joined the Montreal Canadiens in January of 1973. His first season ended with Robinson and the Canadiens hoisting the Stanley Cup, and success continued for the rest of his 20-season career. The 6'4", 225-pound Robinson, who grew up on a dairy farm in eastern Ontario, was among the most intimidating figures in the game.
The Big Bird, that's what we used to call him. He was a tough, tough, tough defenseman.
The Bird. I remember when he first came to the Canadiens, he was long, tall, skinny. I hated playing against him.
Robinson created another level. He could skate, he could move the puck, he could shoot, but he was also very physical in front of the net.
Because of my size, I was always called upon to, you know, play physical and do my part.
Larry didn't, you know, deliver thunderous body checks very often, but when he did...
Hey, remember he put Dornhofer right through the boards one time, I remember that.
Robinson hit Gary Dornhofer into the boards so hard that he literally dislocated the boards, and the maintenance crews had to come out and pound the boards back into shape.
I could handle myself, and I was big enough. But that was the one good thing that I could do, was I was a good skater. Of course, I had a long reach.
And when it all came together, he just exploded onto the scene as a dominant player.
But Robinson's game was about much more than physical dominance. He developed into one of the best two-way defensemen in NHL history.
He was fast, he was good with the puck, he was offensive.
He was so big and could skate and handle the puck, he had a great shot.
Wasn't flashy a lot of times, but he knew exactly where to be.
Larry was a complete player. He was a great offensive player. He was a great defensive player, good team player, and he was very tough.
Robinson, Serge Savard, and Guy Lapointe became known as the Big Three in Montreal. The trio formed the core of what was arguably the best blue line in NHL history and the backbone of the Canadiens dynasty that won four consecutive Stanley Cups from 1976 to 1979.
Our defense was the best in the league by far. We had three all-star defensemen.
I remember playing against Larry when he was with the Montreal Canadiens and the Big Three they had back on the blue line, and just trying to get by a massive guy like that.
It changed the dynamic for Scotty. It changed a lot when you knew you had three of the best defensemen in the National Hockey League.
Probably played an extra couple of years in the league because of him. He was my partner.
There's never been a defense like that. You tell me a defense that there've been three guys on the same club like that. Never been.
Robinson would win a sixth Stanley Cup in 1986 before moving to Los Angeles for his final three seasons. There were plenty of individual accolades for the 10-time All-Star as well. He won the Norris Trophy as the league's top defenseman in 1977 and 1980, and the Conn Smythe Trophy in 1978 after leading all players in playoff scoring. At the time of his retirement in 1992, Larry Robinson had tallied 208 goals, 750 assists, and 958 points, and had appeared in more postseason games than anyone. His play in all three zones of the ice assured that he would remain in any conversation about the best all-around defenseman in NHL history.
I know when I first became a pro, I said, you know what, you know, if I play 10 years, I'll be very happy. And, you know, it was double that. So that accomplishment, along with the fact that, you know, when everything is said and done, I've got six Stanley Cups as a player, and I certainly am proud of that.